DozhaToldya.com.
You know, I've been noticing that some of the shows I've been starting off and the artist been like having a cuss word and YouTube been shadow banning me and stunting my growth, making sure nobody don't see my stuff. And I got to start realizing that. You got to start realizing the self-sabotage. Just like twice. I just almost self-sabotaged myself twice. I seen the computer kind of glitching on the program. I went ahead and reset it. Shit, you got to not allow that shit to get you sometimes. You got to look out for it. You got to know what to look out for so you could avoid being got. Got to know that. If you don't know anything else, you got to know that much. I'm going to go ahead and get this thing started with a little story I'm going to tell y'all about. How I almost got by a fake page. That much. I almost got.
Yeah.
Alright, yeah, that was a little echo, my bad. Fake page tried to get me though, y'all, the other day, man. Posing as my mama, asking for some money for medicine. And did this. I tried to, you know, trick them and ask, well, if you really my mama, what's your middle name? Them folks said her full name. Them folks said, fuck you thought. You thought we ain't do our research? The only difference is they tried to AI me. They sure did pull up her name, but the damn dummies, they pulled up her entire name. They pulled up her first, last, and middle name. And so then I was like, nah, that ain't gonna work. I got you, bitch. You ain't gonna scam me. And then they went to, yeah, this for real. Real true story, start to show off with. Then they went to saying, son, why you not gonna send me the money? This is just how I talk. They like went to trying to guilt trip me. It was crazy. I was like, damn. You got to know what to look out for, man. These scammers out here, man, getting real crafty. I'm just letting y'all know, man. These folks out here getting real crafty with the scams. I don't know if it's AI. I don't know if it's Steph Curry. Yeah, I don't know. It's one of them. But yeah, man, one time, mic check. It's your boy Dame Doja, DozhaToldya.com presents the Doja Toldya Podcast.
Number, you're listening to Doja Toldya Radio.
Number 106. Pressing every button but the right button. It's Doja Toldya Podcast. Number 106. All right, we got the chat up in there. We got the chat up in there. We got Black and Wild in the building. Shout out to DJ Shed Street. It's his birthday today, man. Shout out to DJ Shed. Y'all wish DJ Shed a happy birthday. And told him Doja Toldya, man. Y'all go check him out every Sunday right here on Doja Toldya Radio. He on his 50th show coming up. I don't know if he's going to do a show this Sunday, but his next show is going to be his 50th show on Sundays, 10 o'clock to 12 o'clock. Find the link right here on Doja Toldya, the same way you listen to this show right here. As a matter of fact, it's right there. Just go to that link on Sunday, man. Meet us here, man. It's going to be a great show. Yeah, 50 shows in, man. Congratulations on that, man. 50 shows in. In case you don't know, man, you can always check out DJ TC Fridays and Saturdays. Fridays at 8:30, Saturdays about 2:30. depending on what he got going on for the weekend. But yeah, follow him on Twitch at DJ T-C-E-Z-Y, T-C-E-Z. And yeah, man, shout out my brother. And also happy birthday to my other brother, my late brother, TJ, man. Rest in peace, and shout out to TJ, man. Rest in peace. I'm going to take a moment of silence real quick for my brother TJ. Let me take a drink. Let me take a moment of silence for my brother, man. I miss him. And we're keeping this thing going. In his memory, in his spirit, he is with us through his kids, Mariah and Tristan, and even through my nephew, Sasa. He is with us. His spirit is always with us, man. And we miss you, brother. TJ, Tristan Jones. Rest in peace, man. We're going to take a quick moment of silence. Let me see if I wasn't really even ready to do any of this. I guess I should have thought about it, but that was just kind of spur of the moment. I just was like, well, let me shout out my brother real quick. Spur of the moment type stuff. But I don't know, man. I know he believed in me a lot. So we're going to take a quick moment of silence, man. Also, I might fix this camera for a second. So give me a quick second. Rest in peace, TJ. My loud mic. Y'all probably heard me in the background. Rest in peace to my brother. My brother, TJ. Oh, man. Is the mic working? Okay, there we go.
Step to the right. We headed to the dive bar.
Oh, hold on. Don't do it like that. Don't do it like that, B. Miss you, brother. All right, man. I guess I'm making it sad now, and I got to kind of bounce out of this sadness. Make the show one of them bad shows, and it's already starting off bad. I got to switch everything up. Y'all give me a second, man. Let me break out of this. Let me break out of this real quick.
We got London on the track.
Check.
Yeah, bitch.
All right, I think I bounced back, man. I know I got to get a new cord. This cord is very sensitive. It's very messed up cord. And I don't know what's going on with my Facebook feed. I hope everything's coming in clear, man. I apologize for the delays. I was kind of just throwing off today because I have already been drinking because I've been celebrating my brothers. And yeah, so shout out to DJ Shed Street and shout out to my brother TJ, man. As the end of the month and Easter weekend is upon us. Is the kids off tomorrow? It's Good Friday tomorrow, ain't it? It's Good Friday tomorrow. You know, kids should be out of school. Everybody should be, you know, getting ready to hit the beaches again and hit the streets. And spring break is upon us, and kids is getting, you know, out of school. I already said that part, but, you know, it's like this is that time where sun coming back out, but it's still been cold outside. It's just eerie out there. All kind of crazy stuff been happening. Just when you think that we can take a week off, I gotta come in and give a good show. I want to be celebrating my brother, you know what I'm saying, and going to another country or something like that. But nah, we got to come in and do a whole nother show. But it might be worth it because I owe y'all an apology for not talking, you know what I'm saying, not covering Diddy, trying to cover up for him for so long. So yeah, we got to talk about that. I guess we gonna get straight into it. It's some music that dropped as well, so we kind of excited about the music that's dropped. So, you know, we got to talk about this Future situation. We got to talk about this Kendrick situation. So, you know, how do we start this thing off, man? I am a little thawed today, but there is a balance in the industry again, and there's going to be even more of a balance because Beyonce dropping tomorrow. So this, like, it's getting hot out here. There's some music that's out here brewing, you know. There's some music out here, man. We can't even front, man. All right, I know what I want to start the show off with. Today's show, we're going to start off talking about female rap and how Future just set a balance to the industry, right? To hip hop. And then we'll get into the beef and all that. But to start this thing off, you know, I've been playing a lot of Glorilla. I've been playing a lot of Cardi B. We've been playing a lot of Nicki Minaj. You know, Megan Thee Stallion had the number one record early in the year with his. Even though that record went away mighty fast, who knows how she got that number one? You know, we ain't going to speculate here, but we're just going to give her that. Go ahead and give her the props. She did get her number one record out of the year. Before that, Uzi Vert had a number one record. Before that, I think the last rap number one was a Drake record, wasn't it? Oh no, it was Jack Harlow. Lovin' on Me was also another rap number one. And I'm just gonna say, I'm saying all this to say that besides the ladies, I think Doja Cat also had a rap number one, right? So besides the ladies having the opportunity to go number one, you had to have a pop record. It was just real hard. Hold on. See, that came out of nowhere. My bad, Facebook. My bad, YouTube. Y'all let me ride, man. But that's exactly what I'm talking about. You know what I'm saying? That song could come out of nowhere. And when that song come on, am I supposed to act like I don't like it? Like, this is a very, very hard time. I ain't going to front. Never seen no time like this. Not like this time. To where you have to be in the club. Well, yeah. I guess I was a fan of Foxy Brown. But you got to be in the club and celebrate and get crunk off Glorilla, Yeah Glow, or Sexy, Get It Sexy. Then they may come back around and play Pound Town, or they may come back around and play Fuck Nigga Free. Then they gonna come back around and play some Cardi B, you know. Then come back around and might even play, you know what I'm saying, Think You a Shit, You Really a Fart, or might even call you a munch with the music. And so you just got to take it. Like, shout out Flo Millie, man. Shout out to, you know, AR the Mermaid. Shout out to Anicia. And, you know, shout out to Nicki Minaj, of course, the queen of this shit. You know, shout out to Queen Latifah. Shout out to MC Light. MC Light got a new song out right now. The ladies is just really doing their thing, man. They running shit. And I just want to know, why is it frowned upon when dudes listen to female music? Like, if I play Get It Sexy and I like the Sexy Red song, it's like I got to hide and listen to it. I got to, like, sneak around and be like, yeah, let me get this was pre-Future, you know, before Future restored balance, man. It was getting kind of hectic out here. Cause I ain't gonna lie, I was listening to Glorilla in the car, like, you know. I was listening to Flo Millie, you know. I'm conceited, you know. I'm very secure in my manhood. I ain't tripping. It was hard for me, you know, to listen to Pound Town. You know, I ain't gonna front. But when she said "Shake Them Dreads," I was with it. She said, what? Fuck my baby daddy? I went with all that, no Diddy. But Cuban on Cuban, yeah, Black and Wild. Yeah, Glow, they'll say, you know, it's hard. It's hard not to jam out when Yeah Glow come on. I don't care. But I came up listening to, you know, Lauryn Hill and also Janet Jackson, being a fan of people like Toni Braxton, even TLC with T-Bars and Left Eye and Missy Elliott even. So you wouldn't really feel no type of way with listening to females rap. Eve, shout out to Eve. I don't feel no type of way about it. But I understand that folks is, you know, calling people out for listening to Sexy Red and enjoying themselves. You can't really be no dude. You got to just watch yourself. You know what I'm saying? You know, you got to be extra hard these days or whatever. You know what I'm saying? They got new words like no Diddy. And others. But all right, man, we're going to have to get this thing moving, man. I know I'm kind of bull junking around. But y'all help me out with that, man, because it's tough. It's tough out here dealing with all these rules. You got to say pause. You got to watch out for, you know, all these entertainers now. And I guess we got to start calling a spade, you know, all week long. You know, I have to say, I learned my lesson a lot. When there's smoke, there got to be fire. I learned my lesson, you know. When my brother was on my... He was on my case. I had to switch the words up. He was on my case about, you know, not speaking about the Diddy topics early on. And I wasn't really talking about them. But I must say, it's looking kind of bad for Diddy right now. Even though I still feel like it's deep in a rap. It's deep in a rap, so I don't know what I'm saying. You know, I ain't gonna get into it all the way. Let me just shout out to Eve real quick. What's this new song that they've been dancing to? Y'all been seeing folks do this dance? Look like Eve might be back. I've been seeing folks do this dance and I've, you know, just been wondering. What's this move? What's this new? Is this Afro Beats or is that some piano or whatever they call it? I don't know. Somebody let me know. Whatever. We're going to do the research and we're going to let y'all know. But shout out to EVE. Like I said, man, I came up listening to female rap. That was good. So that don't mean I was in the club singing. I was in the club singing Lil' Kim. But, you know, when Foxy Brown come on, it was kind of rough when Foxy Brown came on, man. It was hard to not vibe. And now when Sexy Red come on, it's going to be hard to not vibe. It's going to be hard to not vibe, man. But now, you know, we got Future restored the balance to the industry. So it's all good. We can get back to business. Hold on, man. I'm totally like blowing it today. But y'all remember when that shit came on, man. shit. What that is? Hey. Know you was going to be jamming when I was saying that Foxy Brown came on. Tell me you wasn't. You singing the lyrics. You ain't even have to say no Diddy. But now, you can't even do that. Because of stuff like what Diddy done did, man. What did Diddy do, man? Diddy did that shit, man. He did something. All right, man. So, yeah, I guess I use my whole intro just kind of talking about nothing. So I guess I might as well just go ahead and get right back into back to business. Future is back in the streets. We don't trust you. For anybody who got any problems with Metro, Future, or Kendrick Lamar, we don't trust you. And you can just keep your opinions. Keep it all to yourself. All right. What y'all think about the album, man? How many times y'all skip in the album? I don't even know the name of the songs. I just like let the whole album play. Like it's hard to even deny how perfect the marriage between Future and Metro Boomin, man. Metro Boomin, you did your motherfucking thing, man. Congratulations, man. Oh my goodness. What's your favorite track? Like That, of course. The number one song in the country right now. Like That.
I'm happy as f- I shouldn't be. I shouldn't even be this f- happy. I'd be like, man, it's so much shit that about me that's not right. Man, why I'm this happy? I'd be like, man, I don't even, because it's just, I'm living my dream.
Yeah, man. That boy's back, man. The restored balance to the galaxy. Future and Metro Boomin drop, We Don't Trust You. And it is possibly a classic. It might be a classic. I might be hyping it up right now because I ain't had, you know, we ain't had no good music for the streets dropping so long. I think the last album that I was very excited about, shout out to French Montana, that Mac and Cheese 5, that ended up being a real, real good album. But last album, I think, was Offset that I could really get excited about. No disrespect to Kanye, but all disrespect to Kanye. All disrespect to Kanye. But yeah, man, what y'all thought about the album, man? You know, shall we get into it? Shall we run a quick review before we talk about this song? I seen some folks saying that Kendrick Lamar's verse was mid. I don't know how that can be possible. I think that Metro Boomin might be making a move for one of the greatest producers of all time. I've already had a couple of debates about it earlier, and I'm going to go ahead and state my claim on saying that Metro Boomin might be, Metro might be the GOAT. You know, no disrespect to Kanye. Well, all disrespect to Kanye. No Diddy. Anyway. We Don't Trust You, man. Young Metro, Ice Attack, type shit. Now that's a run. It starts off with We Don't Trust You, which lets us know that they might be talking to Drake. I'm just going to go ahead and get straight to it. Let's just let you know. Metro has had issues with Drake. Future has had issues with Drake. We don't trust you, Drake. We don't trust you around our women. That's basically what it is. We just don't trust you. That's just basically what it is. You know what I'm saying? Drake the Snake Roberts got these boys out here. And when you see his last album was I Never Liked You, you know, they make you think. Future's last album was I Never Liked You. And then he came back with We Don't Trust You. Is he... The writing's on the wall, felt people. People trying to figure out what happened, what kind, what, who was the chick's name? Is her name Diana? What's going on? But in that first couple of lyrics in the song, actually, he's saying in the ad libs when the album come on. I'm gonna blank the music part out. But if y'all on Twitch or and y'all on for everybody that's on Mixler, y'all gonna hear the whole show. So that boy Future is like he real methodical with the way he do things too. You know what I'm saying? Like, I just want to say at the beginning what they start saying: hate written all over you, fake written all over you. Oh man, did they got the did Metro come in with his old hit? Metro be sending shots in faces, sometimes pretend to be your friend. So, y'all remember that, man. Y'all write that one down. All right, so we gonna cut this up right there or whatever. Let them folks know. Future started the album out saying hate written all over you, fake written all over you. And then Metro got his smiling faces, fake friends, you know, trying to be your friend. I think I said that wrong, but y'all know what I meant. Y'all know what I meant. Pretend to be your friend. Yeah. Smiling faces, pretending to be your friend. And we get plenty of that. So right there, they get the doggone album started like the right way. And he seemed to keep it toxic, keep it street, and give us the album that we be wanting. Now, that last album was kind of hard too, but it wasn't like this one. It wasn't like this one. So I'm just a little happy. I know I'm not really as hyped as I probably should be, but now we got to question ourselves. Who is really the top? Who is really the big three? Who the top five rappers of this new generation? We always talk about Kendrick. We always talk about Drake. We always talk about Drake. We know Jay-Z is the old folks' goat. And some folks want to throw out Nas out there, you know. Then you got Lil Wayne, the GOAT after that. Then this generation's GOAT is Drake, but a lot of folks aren't big fans of Drake like that. So that goes to say, you know, another point that my brother was pointing out this weekend, saying, hey, just because it goes platinum or just because the masses deem it great and deem it pop don't mean that it's the gospel. Yeah, don't mean it's the gospel. Well, that's crucial. Yeah, so let's get into it, man. who is the top five MCs, rappers, and why do we skip over Future? I know why for a while, but then after I've been saying it for a good little couple of months now, that Future probably one of the best songwriters of all time, especially in hip hop, and it's starting to show. Cause I don't really be knowing like which Future song is not one of them ones no more. There was once upon a time where I could be like, man, you know, when he had the songs like Trophy and basically when he'd be singing to the girls, you know, when he was in his Sierra moments, where I was kind of like questioning Future, you know, I was kind of questioning him back then. But ever since he broke up with Sierra, the man been walking around like he the human torch, man. The man just been, you know, he been King Midas, man, with the music, man. The Dirty Sprite too. I Never Liked You, Future Hendrix. He been going crazy. And it's a lot of hits out there, man. Future really, really, you know, he may make you question who is really the top. And of course, everybody gonna say Drake, whatever, but you know, there's a mean machine behind Drake, man. We just gonna say that. And Drake has dropped a lot of dud albums. People be trying to act like they, you know, of course, he always gonna have a monster hit. And he's a great artist. He, you know what I'm saying? Real, real good at rapping and all that. I ain't taking nothing away. He is one of the best rappers, you know, and artists to do it. But he be letting the nigga down a whole lot. And I don't never really get into his music as much as other people may claim to get into his music. Especially when it's just him. When it's a feature or something like that, or he kind of, you know what I'm saying, taking somebody's style, that's one thing. But other than that, if it's just him, I don't know. And on this album, it got features, of course, Future got features from Travis Scott, The Weeknd, Kendrick Lamar, and Rick Ross. But it's just Metro Boomin and Future for the most part, you know. And Playboi Carti, the Weeknd. But I don't know, I kind of beating around the bush and trying to not get into the fact that Kendrick Lamar showed his ass once again. And he showed y'all, you know what I'm saying, you know, that he ain't playing around. And I know a lot of folks don't really like Kendrick like that, whatever. They talk a lot of noise about Kendrick taking a long time to drop. But that's because he could just drop an album and that music gonna last like two, three years. Because the music is just that great. And he gonna go around and do shows and you know, and beat Kendrick. So Kendrick was another one of those people that I've been saying for the longest. It's one of them ones. Pop another bottle if you like that. And them folks been trying to deny me like I ain't know what I was talking about. These niggas talking out of they neck. Tell them, Kendrick. I can't even play it because they gonna flag me. But y'all know what it was. And then when people say, oh, Kendrick had, like they said that he didn't really have, it was mid, he didn't really have like no punchlines, or this was a mid verse. I want to say something to the people that says, you know, Kendrick's verse was mid. We don't trust you. Like, we just don't trust you. Because this song finna be the number one song in the country. It's a Future song, so it, like, and it's kind of like a club kind of like song, so it's not like he was supposed to just get intellectual lyrical on there. But y'all said that this verse was mid, and I've heard mid Kendrick verses before. But not this one. Mm-mm. It wasn't the best Kendrick verse ever, but the way he raps and his words is what you got to factor in with Kendrick. You got to factor in the actual performance of Kendrick Lamar and the certain words that he gonna throw out there to kind of make it stand out. Even though he said all, and then it kind of throw you off because he said all, but the all part is kind of like it's gonna carry you to the next part. These niggas cooking up. Okay, let's get it, bro. But cannot be legit. No 40 water. Especially when he say, I know how many of y'all been walking around saying, for no reason, bomb! Nigga, boom! Kendrick gave them the ad lib. So that's why, man. K Dot is K Dot. That boy say he paranoid, man. He got PTSD. I don't know, you know, if it's a hater or a friend. Like they said earlier in the album, smiling faces pretend to be your friend. You don't know who to trust. And I told y'all got to be very selective early in the show. Remember, I told you, you got to know what to look out for. You got to know how to see the signs. Everybody might not be there for you. It's a competition out here. These folks want to be the one. It can only be one sometimes. And you got to know when it's time to be that one, and it can only be that one, and you want to be that one. You got to know when to put it on and let these folks know you that one.
Just big me, nigga. Bum. Stepping number if you like them.
Yeah, but I know how many. I know a lot of y'all had been saying bum all week long. I know I have. So that is oh yeah, man, I'm messing up. I got a lot of stuff going on. But that's the thing that separates Kendrick though. It's the fact that he wants to be number one. You gotta know. You gotta want to be number one out here. You gotta know when it's time to stand out and when it's time, you know, to be that guy. So let me just move on, man, because I'm kind of dragging on this show, or whatever. And I apologize. I just had a very, very distracting day. You know, I'm just gonna blame it all on Shed Street. That's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna blame it on my brother Shed for making me drink early in the day and throwing me off. And shout out to for Future for bringing us in the balance to the show. I mean, balance to the galaxy. Bringing us back. Toxic music is back out. We can ride around, you know, to some music finally, because it was getting kind of rough out here, man. We was out here listening to a whole lot of sexy, you know. And it was all good, because I don't see nothing wrong with listening to sexy. I don't see nothing wrong with it. It is what it is. All right, so let me see where we at, where we at, where we at, what we got going. I've just been freestyling, saying whatever. I ain't been going off of no clips. Supposed to be pulling up clips on y'all. Diddy House right there. All right, so this supposed to be a part of the beef. Let's get into this part of the beef real quick. Let's pull this video up. See what this young lady's talking about.
Regular girl. I'm just a regular person. It ain't about me.
Cap.
Nobody's beefing over me. I'm not that important. I'm just a regular girl. I'm just a regular person. It ain't about me. I don't need to address or clear anything up because those who know, and that's all that matters. Yeah, no? So, and guess what? People are going to want to believe what they want to believe. So it doesn't matter what I clear up. Nigga doesn't care. He's laughing at this. He literally don't give a f-. He's not going nowhere. I don't know who thought he was going somewhere. Comments off my life. So I could get on live like I used to, like a normal person. I don't work at the club anymore. So, and no, my name is not Amber either. There's nobody named Amber. I'm a witch. Who the fuck said I was black? I'm very much not black. I'm very much Colombian. I don't want to be black, babe. My man just doesn't want me working at the club anymore, so that's why I haven't been there. Because I could talk however I want. Yep, I'm mid as f***. That's what I'm saying. I don't know what the hype's about.
All right, so there we go. This is apparently the young lady that might have been a part of the reason that these two superstar rappers, Future and Drake, have decided to not be friends. Decided to, you know, they decided to go ahead and beef on wax. For one, they decided to share at one point. And maybe it was who had her first, you know, maybe it was Future, you know what I'm saying, Pluto that had her first. But this just make you think about, you know, some of the lyrics. If you go back and check out some of the song titles. Again, like I told y'all, the album title. There was a lot of clues out there that was letting us know I never liked you. Dennis, we don't trust you. Now look at these song titles. They got Slime You Out, Slimed In, Furthest Thing, Drake dropped Furthest Thing. They dropped Claustrophobic, The Shoe Fits. They dropped Cinderella, Trust Issues. Of course, We Don't Trust You. Won't Be Late, Running Out of Time, Treacherous Twins, Where My Twin At, A Night Off, Everyday Hustle, I Don't Give a Fuck. I don't even know what that fucking mean. What the fuck you mean, I guess that's saying. So yeah, man, it's deep in the rap, man. You like your boy, Ross say. Okay, and another thing, I'm dragging. I know I'm dragging with all of this, super dragging with all this. Why is Rick Ross all of a sudden got a problem with whatever? Like, what happened with Rick Ross and Drake? What's going on? Shit get kind of, the rabbit hole get deeper. see where I found that. Where I had that part at. I'm tripping. Seemed like Rick Ross star unfollowed Drake. And Drake sent an invitation to his concert to Rick Ross' ex. I don't see any harm in that. But at the same time, you know, maybe that might have been a shot. But this is the invitation. Christina Mackey, of course, y'all know, you know what I'm saying? Christina Mackey and Rick Ross. Y'all might not know, but the woman Christina Mackey and Rick Ross was together at one point. They end up breaking up about two or three weeks ago. They had a very short relationship. Anyway, she was at the show. Drake sent her the invite. And it's been also revealed that that boy Rick Ross unfollowed Drake some kind of, like, for some reason. So we don't know what happened. Is he just picking sides? You know, if that's what's going on. Rick Ross posted himself vibing. I mean, that's the jam right now. Who ain't gonna bump it, but for my nigga, bum. My boy up in the Wraith, bumping that Kendrick Lamar. Smoking a fat one, you heard me? So, yeah. Seems like he's picked sides. Oh, he also said this. Dropped this on us.
Hating on you this morning. Good. Because if they hating on you this morning, that lets you know that confirms everything you've ever accomplished. You get it without them. You don't need them. And if you don't need them, they ain't got to give you nothing. Tell them to go get that to somebody who's needy. They hating on you this morning. Good.
So what's really going on, man? Why is everybody hating on everybody, man? Everybody turning their back on everybody. My boy Drake say, they their own worst enemy. My boy Drake say he ain't tripping. They rather go to war with me than admit that they are their own worst enemy. Drake said he ain't tripping. Stay over there. So again, man, it's like the Avengers Civil War. And I've been throwed off a little bit because I've been kind of caught up in all these shenanigans. So I hope I was able to deliver it to y'all the right way. But I am excited and I am happy that Future finally restored balance to the industry. Who's going to be next? Is Big Sean going to be next? Why Big Sean always got to have his stuff stepped on by Kendrick? That's a whole nother conversation. Why Kendrick keep stepping on Big Sean releases, man? How did, you know, Big Sean had to have the worst goddamn timing going. All right, let me see. Will Drake respond? Anybody think that, you know what I'm saying? Will he respond? This was the Drake response so far. Will he get in the booth? Will J. Cole get in the booth? This is what we got from Drake so far.
A lot of people ask me how I'm feeling. I'm gonna let you know how I'm feeling. Listen, the way I'm feeling is the same way I want you to walk out of here feeling tonight about your fucking self. Cause you know how I'm feeling? I got my fucking head up high, my back straight, I'm 10 fucking toes down in Florida, anywhere else I go, and I know that no matter what, it's not a nigga on this earth that can
how I want you to walk out of here tonight. But in order to, you know, get yourselves all gassed up, riled up, and move towards the future, sometimes you gotta acknowledge the mistakes that you made in the past, right? 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 So this is what I want you to do. Everybody in here.
I wonder what song he played right after that. Y'all think that was a response? You know?
A lot of people asking me how I'm feeling.
Y'all think that was a response? I was there, you know. Do you think that J. Cole is going to get in the booth? How fast will it take J. Cole to get in the booth? I know this is the boring part of the week. The Diddy part was the more exciting part of the week. So I guess we'll go ahead and, you know what I'm saying, get on with it. But we waiting, man. We just going to keep y'all updated, man. You know, this is just the first week of the number one album. You know, we anticipating Future to be the number one album in the country, him to have the number one song in the country with Like That. We know that Kendrick Lamar is not done. We know that we pretty sure that he was talking to Drake. He got issues with Drake, but J. Cole had to catch a couple of strays because of first-person shooter. We're not so sure if the big three is Drake, J. Cole, and Kendrick. We don't know what the order of the big three. It might as well just call it the big four. You know what I'm saying? You know, the four for four. Because Future said, hey, y'all forgot about me. And Kendrick say, it's just Big Me. So, hey, we vibed out. We vibed out. So, man, you know, I'm excited. We're going to keep y'all posted, man. And we're going to move on to the next topic, man. Let's keep this thing rolling. I appreciate y'all. I spent a whole hour on Future and just talking about Future and Sexy Red so far. That's crazy. All right, so I guess we got to run through the rest of these topics. Man, we got Cowboy Carter. Beyonce dropping Cowboy Carter, man. What y'all going to do? What the Beyonce fans going to do now? Didn't she just drop something like a couple of weeks ago? Didn't Beyonce just have y'all at the Renaissance concert just a couple of days ago? Like, Beyonce know how to get that money, man. Shout out to B, man. Cowboy Carter is coming out tomorrow. They say it's not a country album, it's a Beyonce album. But we look like she's on a horse. She got on the hat. People was talking noise because of the American flag that she had. And it looks to be a country album to me. So, because they got Texas Hold'em. You know, she already done dropped a couple of country songs. So, of course, this is Act 2. Cowboy Carter, Beyonce dropping tomorrow. We'll be talking about it next week. So be on the lookout for that, man. Be on the lookout for it. I might even listen to this. I ain't gonna lie, I ain't even listening to Renaissance. I did like one or two times. I don't think I'm listening to this one either, because if she coming with the country music, I might be straight. But I know that at least Future got 1 week to be the number one album in the country, because she damn sure going to be the number one album in the country. That's for sure. And word on the block that Future might be doubling back and dropping again. But Beyonce finna, know what I'm saying, wrap up the damn charts with damn near like the first. She going to have like five records in the top 10, and it's gonna get ugly for anybody who want to drop in the next couple of weeks. I'm just gonna put it like that, because Cowboy Carter finna take over the streets. Shout out Lady Indiana, checking in. I see you, Lady Indiana. Shout out to DJ TC. Once again, my bad, TC. I've been missing the show a little bit, been having a lot. You know what I'm saying? You know, I've been recording people on the studio on Fridays, but I be tuning in early. You know, the early vibe around 8:30 on Friday with DJ TC. So make sure y'all come vibe, man. I don't know. He might play some Beyonce, Cowboy Carter tomorrow, you know, but I probably won't be playing that shit. I ain't going to front. Nah, I'm lying. I like the Texas Hold'em song. I thought I wasn't going to like it. I end up liking it. Juvenile released a video. Juvenile released a video, 400 Degreez, 25 years after the release of the album. How y'all feeling about that? How y'all feeling about your boy Juvie, man? 25 years later, decided to say, hey, man, y'all needed this. Juvie say, November 3rd, 1998, Juvenile released his third studio album, 400 Degreez. The album went on to be certified 4x platinum, having sold over 4 million copies. This groundbreaking album remains Juvenile's best-selling project of his solo career. This visual is a celebration of the 25th anniversary of this monumental achievement. So, but it's on November 3rd, 1998. Is that even 25? That's over. Anyway, I don't know. I don't feel like doing no math. That don't seem like right math. But anyway, we'll figure it out. But shout out to Juvie, much more powerful than, because it wasn't a bunch of singles. You really had album cuts that you would hear only in the club, and they just rang off. And then everybody, when the DJ kind of cut the record and the music come on, I'm saying, you know what it was as soon as it came on. You knew not to play around with them. You know what I'm saying? As soon as it come on, you know. You know what I'm saying? Everybody gonna say, I bought that. You know? You knew what it was. But I was very, very excited to see this. Juvenile, you know what I'm saying, you know, had a good Tiny Desk. Had Manny Fresh off in the Tiny Desk, and the music was well received. So I think that this was a great decision. And I encourage our artists of all levels to re-release music videos for singles that they didn't really push, or, you know, might have just got skipped over for whatever reason. Why not? You crazy. He possibly could, you know, start charting again with that. Of course, it's going to do well on YouTube, and you could probably make a couple of months and streaming dollars from the YouTube from redropping the 400 Degreez. I know it's going to go crazy on YouTube. Matter of fact, that's just a given. So, yeah, man, congratulations, man. Shout out, man, to Juvenile for re-releasing 400 Degreez, man. 25-year anniversary, man. And we old, man. I was in the club getting jiggy to that song, man. If I ain't a hot boy, then what do you call that? If I ain't an old nigga, then what do you call that? If I ain't old as hell, then what do you call that? Nah. All right, man, we kind of going over an hour, man. So let me try to get rid of some of these topics, and then we're going to go hard on part two. I promise to deliver a more normal, well-put-together show for part two, man. You know, I apologize for being a little throwed off. I'm going to get my act together, man. I'm going to go to the store and get me some motor drink. Man, we finna get twisted. What else I got over here? You're a bunny rabbit, Meek Mill. You're a bunny rabbit. Why don't you act like one? You're a bunny rabbit, Meek Mill. Hop like a bunny.
You got your ass beat. Keep going. Count out loud. Count out loud. Why are you doing bunny hops, Meek? Because you got your ass beat in tennis. You got your ass beat. Keep going. Count out loud. Count out loud. Keep going. Don't cheat on your bunny hops. They suck. Your bunny hops suck. You got
your bunny hops suck, Meek Mill. You're a bunny, Meek Mill. What y'all think, man? This clip of Michael Rubin making Meek Mill jump up and down like a bunny doing bunny hops after losing in a game of tennis started to go viral, and people, you know, are in an uproar and also just using it to poke fun of Meek Mill by saying Meek Mill, you know, is controlled, I guess. They trying to say that he's a bunny. Say he out there bunny hopping. I ain't saying, you know, he lost a bet. Don't start that, TC. You talking about damn Meek. He lost a bet, man. You know? We just going to say it like that. He lost a bet. TC read it. TC like, damn, Meek Mill. Said it. So... You know what I'm saying? Got my man out there bunny hopping. Yeah, man. He lost a bet. It's not like Coming to America. You know. They say bought like a dog. A big dog. Got my boy bunny hopping out there, man. There was a couple other clips of Meek Mill who I ain't gonna say they were of Meek Mill, you know. I mean, let me take that back. There were a couple other alleged things said about Meek Mill and I guess we could get into that stuff and close out with the Diddy situation. Cause I'm acting like I'm about to skip the Diddy situation right now. So, I don't know if y'all know what I'm talking about. So, before I get into that, I'm finna just play this real quick. So, hold on.
Oh, you're fine. Beautiful. It's just that if we're going to be married, I thought we should talk to each other, get to know each other.
Ever since I was born, I've been trained to serve you.
Yes, I know this, but I would like to know about you. What do you like to do?
Whatever you like.
What kind of music do you like?
Whatever kind of music you like.
Look, I know what I like. And I know you know what I like because you were trained to know what I like. But I would like to know what you like. For instance, do you have a favorite food?
Yes.
Good! What is your favorite food?
Whatever food you like.
They say that this is your Miami and Diddy.
Listen, from this moment on, I command you not to obey me.
No.
Are you saying that no matter what I tell you to do, you will do?
Yes, Your Highness.
Anything I say, you do?
Yes, Your Highness.
Bark like a dog.
Arf! 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 Arf!
A big dog.
Woof! 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 Woof!
Hop on one leg.
Woof! 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 Woof!
Make a noise like an orangutan.
Ah!
I see the two of you are getting along.
Yeah, man. Is this Young Miami and Diddy? Or is it Michael Rubin and Meek Mill? Which one of the two is it? Which one of the two is it? Oh, I done messed up my sound effects. Man. I can't even do my bad jokes. Which one of the two is it, man? I know. These are all bad jokes. Y'all got to excuse me. Let me get myself together. All right, so I do not have that sound, TC. TC is asking me if I have the sound from allegedly Meek Mill and Diddy behind closed doors. We don't know if that's real. And I ain't even I can't get into that one. That one was kind of nasty. That's kind of nasty, TC. For you to even talk about it, that means you might have even heard it, you know. No Diddy. No Diddy. You know what I'm saying? We ain't going to do that. Nah, see? We can't even do it. You know what I'm saying? Like, I don't know, man. I don't know what to think about. No, I don't know what. You know, you just don't know what's real no more. You just don't know what's real no more, man. What's going on, man, out here, man? Pause, man.
Oh, shit, nigga. Oh, man. Oh, fuck. Fuck shit, nigga. Fuck nigga.
Crazy, man. I don't know where none of this is coming from. You know, there's something wrong with my computer, man. Hold on. Let me try to fix it. No Diddy. Pause all this. You know what I'm saying? No Diddy. Yeah, yeah. Just like that, overnight, pause have officially been changed to no Diddy. We no longer have to say no homo. We no longer have to say pause. It is now no Diddy. I ain't going to try to cover up for the guy no more. It is what it is. You know, if there's smoke, there's fire. Where there's smoke, there's fire. You know, if it walk like a duck and quack like a duck, then it might be a goddamn, yeah. I don't know if any of these things, you know, I'm not saying any of these things are true, but a lot of these rumors have been going on for years and years and years, and they keep getting closer and closer to being, you know, actual proof. So, hey, man. I say Diddy should have came out a long time ago and been like, hey, man, I like to party. I like to get freaky. You know, I'm bisexual, whatever. If he would have came out a long time ago, you know, it would have been whatever. What'd you say? No AI, it's DI. No AI. That might be AI. I don't know what that was, man. We don't know what that was. They say, remember, somebody might have had a phone to the doggone door. And then next thing you know, they kept watching the door, and then Meek Mill walked out the door. Oh, man. TC getting the kick out of this. You know what I'm saying? TC is getting the kick out of all this. But, all right, so how we start this thing off, man? How do we begin, man? First and foremost, I know it's late in the show, but y'all were right. Y'all were absolutely right. You know, y'all, for everybody that told me that I was skipping over Diddy and I didn't want to talk about Diddy, and when folks get caught up in peculiar situations, you know, you might have to believe them. Like this was one of them. I ain't really even going to speak on this one because this is not the topic that we're talking about right now, so we're going to skip over that. Hold on. Yeah. Get that out of here. Diddy House was raided, man, over the weekend, man. Had his sons in handcuffs, Homeland Security. Shit was on the news, on CNN, on all Fox, all the news stations. They was trying to figure out what the hell was these folks off in Diddy House looking for. And it all happened on the weekend anniversary of Biggie Smalls' Life After Death release. So how eerie is that?
Holmes, the rapper and music executive, perhaps being linked to a sex trafficking investigation.
He got some shots of a few people coming out of the home. Those people have been detained. Now, we're trying to still connect the dots. We do have some sources on scene here that we're getting this information from. We were actually the first ones here with about different law enforcement vehicles, at least. There are three Bearcats on scene here. This just all unfolded, Sandra, I would say, less than 10 minutes ago. We got here even before the crime scene tape came up. So we're just down the hill. If you look up the street where Tony is right now to the right, you'll see one of those Bearcats and law enforcement. On the other side of those bushes, basically, is that home that is registered to Bad Boy Films, which is part of Bad Boy Entertainment. And the home, in particular, is registered not only to Bad Boy Films, but to one of P. Diddy's daughters.
They are heavily armed, and they've been very tactful, would probably be the best word to use, as they made entry into this home this afternoon. We actually watched them as they made their way through one of these side gates, and as soon as they got inside the home, one of the first things they did was made their way into this garage that you see is open right there. Now, they did take a couple people into custody. We witnessed that. Now, are they under arrest? Are they just being asked about what they know? That I can't answer, but I can tell you there's three people right there that were taken into custody, were inside that home at the time of the raid.
We did see a bunch of
All right, so yeah, they raided his home, man. The chickens are coming home to roost. Shit was crazy. It was like a damn movie, man. It was like, damn, what did he, you know, what did he do? Man, they were looking for him, trying to track his planes, his jets. Raided all three of his homes, New York, Miami, L.A. Candace Owens says, the feds currently raiding Diddy's house. They already knew what he was up to, but he was going to be the fall guy so that they can protect the people at the top of the ring. You hear that? Candace Owens say, the feds currently raiding Diddy's house, but they already knew what he was up to, but he is going to be the fall guy so that they can protect the people at the top of the ring. They are raiding his home to hide evidence, not to find it. That's how this works. I don't know, man. Oh, Candace. Oh, man. We're going to talk about Candace more on part two, but she might have dropped a jewel with that one. She might have dropped us as they say, a Scooby-Doo clue. Well, a Scooby snack with that one. Ryan Garcia also said some of the same thing, something similar. And I guess that was the same tweet. Ryan Garcia say they raided to hide more. So what we need to do is to pray for the law enforcement to grow some balls and leak out what's really out there. Diddy the puppet, Diddy the decoy to distract you to what is actually going on. Don't lose sight. So in other words, they saying that Diddy has evidence, has leverage on some of the high ranking celebrities, A-listers, B-listers, damn it, anybody who has been in L.A., Miami, and New York and had some money, they done partied with Diddy. They say Diddy has allegedly had minors, a Rolodex of sex workers on payroll, that he drugs the liquor, that they put, like, you know, Molly in the liquor and stuff like that and make everybody drink the Ciroc and the De Leon. They got, you know, roofies or whatever it got in it, and they go to getting freaky. But he got cameras and all through the house, so he got evidence of whatever, know what I'm saying, some of that sneaky freaky stuff that these folks been doing. Diddy got the evidence, and that is what they actually have been looking for when they raided his home, or that's what they might be covering up. Yet another person who may not be a good friend of Diddy's, but really knows how raids and all that stuff, you know what I'm saying, and trials and all that stuff plays out. That boy Suge said the people raid Diddy wasn't for people. The raids Diddy Oh, the raids today wasn't for Diddy. It was to destroy the incriminating stuff on powerful men. Epstein, Diddy, Clive Davis. That's what Suge Knight had tweeted. So it's deeper than rapping. Again, on March 25th, 1997, Life After Death is the second and final studio album of the American rapper, the Notorious B.I.G., released on March 25th, 1997 on Bad Boy Records and Arista Records. The double album was released 16 days after Biggie's murder. Crucial. So yeah, man. Deeper than rap. Is this all one big distraction? Is that there's pretty much guaranteed to be a deeper, darker criminal link. There ain't too many people that been stepping up and saying, you know, anything in support of Diddy. We kind of opened up the show with a clip from an early clip from Mase saying, hey, I made it out. And we got a couple of people that said, you know, they haven't known any Diddy to be like that. Then you got some folks to say that he liked that.
What's up, man? How you doing?
Killer, I'm doing good, man. Reparations is getting closer and closer. I'll be sure to give you your percentage.
I ain't got nothing to do with that money. That's all yours, man.
Yeah, man. That's one person that's still laughing and still joyful. My boy May say he got away from that shit. Just imagine. Oh, excuse me. Phone going off. I'm sneezing. Just imagine, though, man, how Mase must feel, man. I played this early. I'm going to go ahead and run it back this, one more time.
Tonight, on whatever date this is, we're all here at this very moment, no matter what path you took to get in this room tonight.
Yeah.
Yeah, so they asked Mase, did he regret walking away from being a rapper? And that's what he had to say.
Or... that wasn't the right decision.
Hold on, man. It's not. Let me pull it back up. Let me pull it back up.
To put it on a general spectrum, this would.
Hold on, let me get it together. All right, here we go.
Like, you could be meant to be something great, but you can decide something different, as we see people do all the time.
All the time.
But you always know the right decision because it's the end result that tell you you made the right decision or that wasn't the right decision.
But you don't know until the end.
You'll know at the end.
Did you make the right decision leaving rap?
I did. Everything now that we see playing out was all the things I escaped. The car, the shine, the loan, the Puff Daddy, the Craig Mack,
Biggie Smalls.
So even though I made those decisions and it cost me money, that's why I got with Killer and they gave me the money back. I didn't lose no money. Destiny.
That boy good.
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 That boy
good.
That boy know.
Nigga said, and that's why he makes the big bucks.
That's right. That made me happy right there because this was filmed. He said that before the raid. And this is what he had to say after the raid had happened. Now, that was May stunting on him before the raid and then after the raid.
I was on the next boat. Yeah, man.
Man. Oh, man.
Closer and closer.
Closer and closer. The big payback.
You, this has been the last year. It's really kind of been the big payback for you, man.
Yeah, man.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, you kind of, last week, you went destiny. You went destiny. You know what happened yesterday, right?
Yeah, man. That's what I'm trying to say. It's going crazy.
What happened?
I'm going to let you start. What did you see that happen?
Oh, yesterday was the anniversary of Biggie Smalls' album, 27 years later. That's what I seen yesterday. That's what I was talking about.
Yeah, that was real. It's amazing that all of this would transpire on that day.
What's crazy is yesterday was Biggie Smalls' 27th anniversary of Life After Death. And it was also the Diplomat Immunity album, 21st anniversary. Shit's going on.
Reparations.
Yeah, man. I was just saying. Yesterday was kind of...
That's eerie, man.
Yeah, that's the word I'm looking for. That's kind of crazy, man. I had no idea that, you know, the internet lets you know, because I don't be knowing these dates for my albums or other people's albums, but they will remind you, man.
Yeah.
That's all you seen?
In a lot.
I've seen
helicopters, all kind of stuff.
Okay.
he a lot of things.
Mase handled that, you know what I'm saying? He had that all right, you know what I'm saying? He had that kind of classy, like. But see, I see it a lot. He talking about what you see.
I'll be sure to give you your percentage.
I ain't got nothing to do with that money. That's all yours, man.
The big payback.
Yeah, man.
Man.
Closer and closer.
Closer and closer. Okay. The big payback.
They be dropping their little, you know, drop a little jewels on them, man. Shout out to Cam and Mase, man. It is what it is, man. The podcast, great show. And hey, that boy walked away, man. Gave his life to God, man. And God might surely be protecting him right now. Craig Mack passed away. Loon went to jail. Shine went to jail. Hell. You got bodyguards that unpassed. Lil' Kim look like how she look. Biggie pass. I don't know, man. It's crazy over that bad boy. That's all I can say. It's just crazy over that bad boy. You know what I'm saying? You know, Dylon ain't do shit. It's crazy over there. There you go. Stevie J. Stevie J and them playing gospel music. Remixing gospel music, trying to get right too. Now that's real wild for Stevie J to actually be having a Biggie shirt on when he done married and got divorced to Biggie's ex-wife. That's crazy. And you see he also tagged Diddy's sons, King Kong's Prince. You know, say, no weapon formed against us shall prosper. So, yeah, man, go get right. Go get right, man. Get right with him. Because it's crazy out here. It's spooky. It's eerie, man. But a couple of things y'all got to remember, man. I don't think that Diddy ever got arrested. They say they found him in Miami. This was him in Miami. He didn't get arrested.
What's going to happen next, Diddy?
He was pacing back and forth. It was alleged that he was in Barbados. They was talking about he had jets in Antigua, all that extra shit. And they had him on tape in Miami, pacing back and forth. Not sure indeed. He probably was about to board a flight. But you want to know what I think? What I think TC is going on is I think that Diddy pulling a little move on him. You know what I'm saying? He put some of the evidence on the plane. Boom. That plane went to Barbados. He didn't get on that plane. He went to Miami. The feds, you know what I'm saying? Caught him up in Miami. But, you know what I'm saying? Evidence is on another plane. You know what I'm saying? It might not have been on his plane. He sent his plane to Barbados and sent another plane to Antigua that they thought he was on. But then he, you know what I'm saying, didn't ever go. And they had him, you know, hemmed up and detained him. And then they just questioning him. You know what I'm saying? A lot of folks are saying that it got something to do with the use. Say the use is after him, word to Kanye West. So a lot of this have happened after he bit the hand that fed him. So my boy Luke, the only one that shot Diddy a little bell. That boy, Uncle Luke, the only one. Tried to shoot him some bell, man.
Fight. Now you want to bite the hand that feeds you. Don't your mama ever always tell you that? Your mama say, never bite the hand that feeds you. And so this is how the major corporations work when you try to come after them. Now you put a lawsuit in. Bam, lawsuit. Fuck that shit. I'm suing their ass. I'm taking their company down. Fuck that shit. They taking my brand and my name and likeness and they making millions of dollars. I want out of this contract. And now, mind you, these people on the stock market, they stock go down 5%, that just cost them some billions. So they're looking at this motherfucker to the shareholders. This motherfucker is affecting our stock. They gotta hold on. You just fucked up some billions of dollars. These are major corporations that are on the stock market that you can affect their stock and cost them in one day billions of dollars by having their stock drop because your sneakers. You telling people you don't want them selling your sneakers. Or you don't want them they stealing money from you, ain't paying you off the liquor. Them people like, hold the fuck on. Okay, get the lawsuit. Now when you get the lawsuit, you got to go to the judge. State judge. They definitely own the state judge because they're going to buy the number one law firm who put the most money into the state judge, into the local judge campaign to make him the local judge. It's big bank take little bank. It goes back to CeeLo. The federal judge, they're going to then find out what senator and congressman that called the president to say, I need an appointment for my federal judge, because how do you get an appointment for a federal judge is because I'm a major donor. And hey man, I got a friend of mine that's a judge, man, on the circuit level. Man, I would love for him to be a federal judge, and I'm gonna max out in your campaign. Matter of fact, I'm gonna generate a couple hundred thousands or $1 million to put in your campaign. You win the seat, you then call up the president. President then say, hey, look here, man, nominate this motherfucker right here. So now you got a fucking judge in here. You got the state judge. So then now you black man who don't own these people company, you want to talk all your cash money shit. And you want to go after these people, what ends up happening? They start the smear campaign because they down with the media. They got to smear you before you go into the courtroom of your peers. They go, okay, we can't settle with this dude. We can't have no voice of reason. He want to act crazy. Now we're going to go after you. Now we're going to call up our same senator. Hey, man, I need you, man, go issue a search warrant, man. I need you to drag this motherfucker. In the hood, that's what we call. I want you to drag his ass. I want you to have all kind of allegations. So by the time he come in this courtroom, he going to wish he ain't know. We're going to take every fucking dime you got. Because we made you. You didn't make us, God damn it. You fuck with my stock. You fuck with my money. You fuck with me. I'm going to fuck with you. I'm going to break your ass down to the lowest term. That's how this shit go, boss. So when you fuck with them people that put that bread in your pocket that made you, they're going to take you down to the lowest terms. Sound like the movie Scarface. Bingo. That's how they do. So you go, they done smeared your name. By the time you get in the courtroom, you lost already because you're sitting up there with a jury looking at you like you're a fucking pedophile and you probably ain't never touched a little girl in your life. And you're trying to sue this major corporation, this major respectable corporation, and they're going to say how many people they employ, how many people, and half the people on the jury drink their shit. Half of the people on the jury, children walking around with their paraphernalia on. You get ready to sue them, and they done made you, through the media, they done made you a crazy man, and they done made you a goddamn pedophile. They done made you everything that you're not. I'm giving y'all some good shit today. Never bite the hand that feeds you. So now when you walk up in that room and you make the deal, you cut the deal with the devil, and then you got one motherfucker, he want to talk about everybody else who's still in the room. You know, that's why I be sitting there looking at that shit. I'm like, he telling on everybody. You know, because you in the room. You know this motherfucker, that motherfucker run that motherfucker. You know. Now you really went rogue.
What y'all think? Uncle Luke giving it up. Uncle Luke giving it up. Never bite the hand that feeds you, man. Let that be a lesson. And you know how we always got to, it's more than what, you know, what meets the eye. He always got to bring up some type of conspiracy. When it was Bill Cosby, we said we said that he was trying to buy NBC. You know, not just Diddy. He saying that he was trying to get independent with his liquor, but he done lost the Ciroc. He done lost the De Leon. He done lost Revolt. You know, we don't know what Bad Boy Records. They talking about Can't Stop, Won't Stop. Them boys said, I think not. They said, think again. You said, can't stop, won't stop. They boys say, oh, no, wait, think again. So it's crucial. It's crucial for the kid, man. Who is they covering up for? Meanwhile, that boy 50 Cent, boy, if for 50 Cent is a savage. All right, we're going to take a quick break, man. We'll be right back with more about Diddy and more about everything, man. We got some more to talk about football. We got to talk about Draymond Green. We got to talk about this bridge that done collapsed. Ice Cube offering people money. Bad Boys coming back. We ain't talk about Kanye been in the news today. So, yeah, man, I apologize for, you know what I'm saying, such a long, drawn-out show, man. I promise y'all part two, I'm going to be a little more, you know what I'm saying, energetic. And then, you know, we're going to get straight to the business. We're going to get right in and get right on out because I got things to do tonight. So we'll be right back, man. We're going to take play some R&B music real quick to mellow the vibe. Then we're going to turn it up at the end. That Sir album is a banger. So if you also looking for, you know, some something to offset all that toxic future shit, you can ride to that Sir. The Sir album is out right now. You got music from, who else? Jordan Lucas also. But yeah, let's get into this this Sir album. What's this one called? You. This is You off the Sir album, man. We'll be right back. It's your boy Dame Doja, Doja Told You Radio, Doja Told You Podcast. You dig?
What's up, y'all? It's your boy Dame Doja. If you're looking to get your interview done or be a guest host on our podcast, hit us up at DozhaToldya@gmail.com. Bump what you heard. Remember who told you? It's Doja Told You.